الناظر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحيتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا اللهم على من عادانا. اللهم ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا ولا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة العالمين سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وعنا معهم إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, in the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah that we bear witness that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is his messenger. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Don't give up if you are a true believer. This is the title. Don't give up if you are a true Muslim, a true mu'min, a true believer. Now, what drove me or what pushed me, what motivated me to say this specific khutbah? Subhanallah, you know, everyone of us, we are browsing the internet, looking here and there, receiving through the social media many things. When you see the extent of slander, the extent of lies, the extent of fake news against Islam and Muslims, it's a mind-blowing. When you just have a quick look on the security and political level, we are witnessing on daily basis how the occupier, how the aggressor with all kind of brutality and rudeness, bluntly doing what he or they want to do, and the victim asking the help, yet the majority of the people who claim, some of them, that they are Muslims with power, or who claim that human rights advocates, no one cares. On the intellectual level, when you see tens and hundreds, if not thousands, of TV programs attacking Islam, when you see very mean people, evil people, liars, they are welcomed on mainstream channels and media just to speak about their experience, how they discovered that Islam is wrong. And subhanAllah, by the will of Allah, all of them, they used to be Salafis, and all of them, they are half of the Quran. When they decide to leave Islam, all of them, they have a father and mother, they were Azhari, and all of them, they were hafiz for the Quran, and all of them, they know the whole book of the Sunnah, and all of them, they were practicing Islam, even though none of them can read the Fatiha correctly. So they are welcomed. You see them attacking, making lies, fabricating a lot of stories. When you keep looking to the political level, real, or keep looking to intellectual or media level, or when you come to all of these, let's say, or in the say faith-based area, when you see these kind of doubts against Islam by many mainstream medias, by politicians, some people might come to the conclusion, or this could lead some people to doubt or to despair, or to hesitate in their commitment to their faith, or to have some kind of fear, or even to decide to abandon their religion because of this horrible attack against Islam. Subhanallah, even though I decided to speak about another topic completely, I prepared since 3 days completely another topic, and it was ready, just the fine tunings yesterday. The idea that I explained, it was in my mind for many reasons, like many of you. Subhanallah, I came to the Fajr, prayed the Fajr behind Sheikh Abdul Aziz. Then he was reading in the Quran, فَلَعَلَّكَ تَارِكُ بَعْضَ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ وَضَائِقٌ بِهِ صَدْرُكَ أَنْ يَقُولُوا لَوْلَا أُنْزِلَ عَلَيْهِ كَنْزٌ أو جاء معه ملك إنما أنت نذير والله على كل شيء وكيل. Before I explain in English, I felt as if Allah is replying us and replying me to the question, and decided to change the full khutbah into the title that you see, which is Don't Give Up If You Are a True Believer. Have we been attacked? Yes. Politically? Yes. Humanly? Yes. Media? Yes. Is the level of lies and hatred equal to the shield that we are protecting? No. Do we have the same political power? No. Actually, 99% of our political leaders, they are working against Islam. Do we have the same financial aid to speak? No. The same media power? No. So mathematically, if we are just normal humans, not true believers, we should give up a long time ago. Actually, why to bother? Why to keep holding this headache? Unless if you, inshallah, I, inshallah, we, inshallah, believers. So that's why, subhanallah, I considered as if this ayah was the answer. Wallahi, I felt as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling me to speak about this topic, which is don't give up. I will go with you in 10 minutes, which is the time that I have, just to listen what Allah says in this regard. Look what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was facing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَعَلَّكَ تَارِكُ بَعْضَ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ. Perhaps you put this ayah in the context that I have highlighted just now. We are under the attack now. Attack. Your religion is bad. You are the source of evil. You are terrorist. You are violent. Even though everyone knows it's exactly the opposite. But psychologically, I'm under attack. What's supposed to happen to me? Look what happened to the one who is better than you and me and everyone else in the creation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says, perhaps you, O Prophet, may wish to give up some of what is revealed to you. What? Allah says, you may wish to give up. Class, I can't stand anymore. The feeling is leaking or could be or might be leaking even to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a human. So Allah is revealing to us, لَعَلَّكَ. Okay? So you may wish, O Prophet, to give up some of what is revealed to you and may be distressed by it because they say, look to the examples they used to say, if only a treasure had been sent down to him or an angel had come with him. You are suggesting, you know, these things. If only, which is just obstacles. We don't want you. So you are trying to attack. You are only a warner. Be careful. It's not your job to change them. The evil people will stay evil. Adam, with all kind of humility and kindness, was not able to affect Iblis, not even 1,000,000%. Iblis stayed Iblis. The evil will stay evil. The wickedness will stay in some of them as wickedness. So don't let this affect you. What is your job after standing fast? In anta illa nadir. You are only a warner. And Allah is the trustee of all affairs. Don't worry. Just keep up doing the good work. Allah continues. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ. Another example about what they are doing to attack you, to undermine you, to let you have the feeling of despair and distress and simply to give up. To give up to be nothing or anything or like them. Which is not the case. You are a Muslim. You are just a slave for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not slave to their ideology or to their group or whatever. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ مُفْتَرَيَاتٍ وَادْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Or do they say he has fabricated this Quran? Exactly what happens in the media now. Quran came from Aramaic, from Cyrenaic, from whatever. So, you know, anyway, you know, someone who's completely hidden, no one knows who is he, no one knows what kind of education he has. Just he will become a celebrity. Out of a sudden, everyone is, what about the scholars? Bring to him a scholar. No, just alone, just to keep throwing these points. What will happen with the people who are might be infected? They are not having the shield of knowledge. Or do they say he has fabricated this Quran? Say, O Prophet, produce 10 fabricated surahs like it and seek help from whoever you can other than Allah if what you say is true. The example that sometimes I use, I would love to highlight. I personally challenge every single person on earth. If you can suggest a system better than Islam to solve the problems of humanity, provide it. Simply quick two examples, alcohol and family through the gate of adultery. Who on earth has the power to speak loudly without interfering or allowing any ruler or party or regime to interfere inside it? Alcohol is prohibited completely. فَاجْتَنِبُوا. Actually, it's not just prohibited. It's prohibited to drink, to sell, to buy, to help, or to carry even in your truck, or to have any kind of investment, or even to sell the fruits like the apple or anything else, or the barley for the factory. All of them, we are doing major sin. Completely prohibited. What is one of the main major reasons for car accidents? What is one of the main major reasons for sexual assaults? What is one of the main major reasons for hitting wives at home by drunk alcohol? Alcohol, alcohol, alcohol. One of the main disasters on earth for humanity is alcohol. Who dares on earth to speak about the prohibition of alcohol except Muslims? This is what I mean. What about families? Who can preserve family on earth now? Because relativism, it's liberalism, secularism means it's up to the society. If they decide it's right, wrong, half right, half wrong, X, whatever. We can't. We can't do this even if he wants. Because it is clear cut. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. It's we. This is the majestic we. That we revealed this Quran, this system, this constitution, and it's we who will preserve. No one can play this game, no one, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zina is haram, close the file. Alcohol is haram, close the file. Riba, what about riba? Who on earth will not be happy if you opened your eyes tomorrow and there is no interest on your mortgage? What will happen with people? Wallahi, they become crazy out of happiness. Who can say for interest? No. On earth, Muslims. This is an example, just to tell you, this is the practical, technical meaning of فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ مِنْهُ مِثْ مُفْتَرَيَاتٍ. Okay, produce like it. It's not just the sound. It's not just blah, 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 blah. No, 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 no. The Quran, it's not a sound. It's a constitution, legislations, guidance. Who can produce something like that? I'm giving you an example about the challenge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is challenging. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَكُمْ فَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ بِعِلْمِ اللَّهِ وَأَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. This is a message for us. But if your helpers fail you, then know that it has been revealed with the knowledge of Allah and that there is no God worthy of worship except Him. Will you not then submit to Allah? This is the title. Don't give up if you are a true believer and a true Muslim. من كان يريد الحياة الدنيا وزينتها, the ultimate. Now, destination for this kind of conflict. Decide with whom you want to be. If Allah favored you, blessed you to be with Muslims, steadfast. Be careful. Don't give up. من كان يريد الحياة الدنيا وزينتها نوفي إليهم أعمالهم فيها وهم فيها لا يبخسون. Whoever desires only this worldly life and its luxurious, we will pay them in full for their deeds in this life. They will enjoy it. Multi-billionaires, multi-millionaires, whatever. Nothing will be left out in this dunya. Finally, أولئك الذين ليس لهم في الآخرة إلا النار وحبط ما صنعوا فيها وباطل ما كانوا يعملون. The end of the story, which is the most horrible or something nice and good for the other party, the believers. It is they who will have nothing in the hereafter except the fire. Final destination. This road leads to this. Either or. No third destination. It's they who will have nothing in the hereafter except the fire. Their efforts in this life will be fruitless and their deeds will be useless. So the decision is yours or mine or ours. So make it wisely. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. Respected brothers and sisters, please convey any message you think that it contains anything of khair, please convey it to your families. I think you agree with me that the majority of Muslims, especially the sisters, they can't or they don't attend the Friday prayer. Even those who pray, many of them, they don't come. So let's always help to convey what you think that there's of khair in any khutbah you listen to any imam. Before I start the dua, inshallah, after we finish inshallah the prayer, 2 to 3 minutes, Brother Dr. Yasser will speak on behalf of REF, which is Resilient Education Fund to empower education for students in Gaza and the West Bank. And this is in cooperation with the UNRWA. Please do your best to listen for a few minutes in case Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enabled any one of you to be participating in a continuous sadaqah jariyah. Allahumma arhamna fawqa al-ardi wa tahta al-ardi wa yawm al-ardi alayka ya kareem. اللهم تقبل شهداءهم يا رب العالمين، داوي جرحاهم واشفي مرضاهم واغفر لهم وتجاوز عنهم وانصر من نصرهم وخذل من خذلهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحمنا وارحم والدينا ووالد والدينا واصحاب الحقوق والواجبات علينا يا كريم. اللهم انا عبيدك ابناء عبيدك ابناء امائك، نواصينا بيدك، ماض فينا حكمك، عدل فينا قضاؤك. نسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك او انزلته في كتابك او علمته احدا من خلقك او استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك، أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا يا رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول